Tonight's extravaganza of openings begins with Pure Imagination Porter from Sukrum's Brewing in Winnipeg. I've had this one before, and it's pretty interesting. It's a lot sweeter than you would expect from a porter. Their flavorings in this thing are reminiscent of maple chocolate chip pancakes. Yum, 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 yum. So the first thing in is electronic components. This one somehow came from Great Britain, so I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure it's not a British seller. It's probably a Chinese seller that's reshipping. That seems to happen a lot these days. It is chips. No, not fish and chips. This is ATtiny 85. It looks like you got 10 of them. So these are just small little microcontrollers. I'm sure a lot of us have heard of these by now. It's the microcontroller that, among other things, is at the core of the DigiSpark. And it's just a capable little chip, a small package, a few GPIO, but it can do a heck of a lot. 10 pieces ATtiny 85-20 PU, integrated circuit, MCU, 8-bit, 8K flash, 8-dip, top ATtiny 85. Deep Learnings is the seller I bought these from. I bought a bunch of stuff from them in the past. They seem to be fairly reliable. Currently, these are going for $20.33 American or $26.46 Canadian with $2.58 shipping. And that's up a little bit from when I bought them, but these things change all the time. As usual, I'm going to link you to the listing that I bought it from, but feel free to use the terms in the title as search terms and try and find yourself a better deal. All right, next in, this was shipped from UAE for some reason, and it says it's adapters. Okay. Holy shit. Well, I'll deal with that later. Let's grab a different knife. What do we have? It's a thing in a bag. It's a conical thing in a... What? That doesn't really tell me anything. I don't remember ordering anything like this. Looks like something you'd clamp in a drill and then, I don't know, sharpen a point on a stick? Maybe? I'm pretty confident that I didn't order anything like that. So scrolling through my orders on all of the sites that I normally buy stuff on, I can't find anything like this at all. Whether in around the time that the envelope says it was shipped or weeks and months before. So I don't know what to make of this. I'm guessing that somebody just either substituted something or ran out of something and just threw a random package in, or they screwed up. I don't know. On to the next item. Well, that was weird. I hope this next one is a little bit better. This one says it is strip light. And that sounds like something I might have ordered. It is. This is an LED strip. Although a pretty shoddily assembled one. Wow. Wonder how many more are wonky like that. That's crazy. So I'm assuming that this was really, really cheap because there's LEDs that are misaligned on it. There's another one. Wow. Shall we see if it works? I'm assuming that it probably does. Does it even say on there what voltage it is or anything? No, not really. But we have 3 per segment. So, and we have a, what is that resistor? 820 ohm resistor. So I'm going to guess this is probably a 12 volt strip. So let's set this guy up here quickly for 12 volts and see what happens. And bring the current up a little bit because it's going to be more than a few milliamps. There, about 3/4 of an amp. That'll do. Okay, let's see what happens. Oh, it turns on. And even the ones that are funky diagonal seem to work. I don't see any that aren't working. Okay. 5-meter LED strip, 600 LEDs, various different sizes of LEDs. I got the 5054 size, waterproof
flexible tape. I got non-waterproof. I got the 50-54 size. And I got white as opposed to warm white. Yeah, they did look sort of more of the bluish, coolish white, but still pretty white. From Bingo LED, these were $9, $9.10 Canadian, and $2.20 shipping. Looks like the listing changed a little bit, but the price didn't, so that's good. And that is pretty cheap, actually, for that length of a strip, I think. So here's the specs for the one that I got. 50-54 SMD LEDs, 5 meter, 600 LEDs, aka 120 LEDs per meter. They're non-waterproof. The cool white, which is what I got, is somewhere between 8,000 and 10,000 Kelvin. They are DC 12 volts. They claim to be 16 lumens per LED. And they have double-sided adhesive, which, yeah, they do. 70 watts per 5 meters. Okay.
Let's put my scalpel back together. There we go. Now then, next package in, we have, what does it say? Cooling fans. Okay. Again, shipped from the UK, but bought more than likely from China. It is two cooling fans. So these are two cooling fans for my 3D printer. You may remember a few weeks back, I replaced this one, which is the hot end cooling fan, because the bearings were starting to get noisy on it, or bushings or whatever. So this one replaces my stock, so I've got a spare again. And this one is more of a squirrel cage style. Can you see the blades in the side of it there? So the air exits out the side and comes in through the face. Oh yeah, there's an arrow pointing to where the air exits. The part cooling fan does exactly what the name implies. Here's a little duct coming out there that squirrel cage blows out, and that blows air across the part just underneath the nozzle to cool it and solidify it quickly, so that the part doesn't slump down on you. 24 volt extruder hot end cooling fan plus fan for Creality Ender 3 3D printer. Got these ones from Hot Yo-Yo, and the two of them together cost me $12.02, and with free shipping. Woohoo! You don't find free shipping as often these days anymore. So if you're shopping for parts for your printer, there's two things to keep in mind. One is the physical size of the things. And that's why I didn't have a part cooling fan. Well, I did have one, but it was the wrong size. So now I've got one that's the correct size. And the other thing to watch out for is the voltage. But the Ender 3 V2 that I have does, in fact, use 24-volt fans. Other than that, there's nothing special about them. They're just fans. And the last thing in, which is also the largest thing, which isn't surprising because that's what I do every time. Let's see what we got in here. Feels like a couple of boxes. And it is two boxes. Oh! Okay, this isn't something they ordered. This is something that Kiwit sent me. And they didn't tell me they were sending it. They just sent these. Okay, I guess I'm on their mailing list now. So we have two pen-type multimeters. Multifunction voltage tester. What model is that one? ST100. And this pen type multimeter is ST120. I'm not going to do full reviews of these, but I will just pop them out of their boxes quickly and see what we got. What is this one? This one is the ST100. As it says, it's just a little pen type meter. Okay. Comes with a couple of AAA batteries. And a couple of probes, typical standard probes that you get with every affordable meter. That's fine. And those plug in back there. What is this up here? That's a non-contact. Oh, there's a manual. Okay. Give me a second here. That didn't take long to find. Yeah, it's a non-contact voltage sensor up at the top. Intensity indicator for that. LCD functions, input jacks. So other than that non-contact voltage thing up at the front, looks like it's just a standard multimeter. Right. Let's see what this other one is, the 120. Again, that and... Oh, this one only comes with one probe, which I assume means that the front of the unit is the other probe. Okay. And other than that, it has, you know, function button and power button and everything else. Okay. Did not expect multimeters today because, you know, they didn't contact me.
I guess it's only fair to look at these things on Kiweed's webpage. I don't have any sale links or discount codes or anything else. I think I remember they sell them on Amazon and a few other places, but since they didn't contact me and tell me where to send you guys, well, here's their webpage. ST100 is currently selling for $23 American. The 120, which is the more simple one, well, it's the one with a single lead, is selling for $21.99, $22 right now. So this guy, its main claim to fame is it's got this non-contact voltage thing up the front here, and then all your other multimeter functions in the backside. This one, it says it can do non-contact using just the probe tip here with its little condom on it. And then you plug your ground lead in the back and you can use it for all your usual multimeter kind of functions. It claims to be able to detect phase sequence, I assume on a three phase. And that's a useful thing if it can do it, because you want to get your phase connections right so that your motor is spinning in the right direction. But I don't know that I'd be using these little handheld, low budget meters for any high voltage. For hobby stuff, it's probably just fine. But other than that, both of them have that same smart mode that we saw on previous Kiweed's meters. It comes up into smart mode and basically you connect it to voltage, AC or DC, or to a resistance, and it just thinks about it for a second and then shows you what you're looking at. As long as your voltages are above, you know, half a volt or something, and your impedances or your resistances are above, I think it was 100 ohms or something like that, then it should find it just fine.
So that was a random and slightly chaotic mailbag. Three things I ordered, three things, I guess, that I didn't order and just kind of showed up. The shipping times on the LEDs was 19 days, the AT Tinies was 27, and the fans was 27 days as well. The fans are, as I mentioned earlier, for spares stock for my 3D printer, because, you know, fans are a wear item. They die over time as the bearings dry out, so it's always useful to have those around. AT Tiny 85s, where was that project? There it is. Remember this little guy I made a while ago? It's just some addressable LEDs and a DigiSpark module in there. And the chip on those DigiSpark modules is that AT Tiny 85. So I think what I'm going to do with the first one of these is replace that in there so that it's just a bare chip. And then the rest of them go into stock, because when I was doing this, I had run out of bare AT Tiny 85s. So now I got 10 of them. And these LEDs, these strips I think I'm going to use on my lighting up above my workbench here. I've noticed that there's a few of these cheap strips up there that a few of the LEDs are flickering on, and they're smaller LEDs anyway, so I'll put these up there, and combined with my new power supply that I got in the last mailbag, hopefully I will have more reliability in the lights and just a little bit more brightness in the lights. It's always good to have lots of light when you're doing this video stuff. Cameras like lots of light. This random ass thing, I have no idea. Do you know what that is? I don't. And then there's these two pen style meters that I got from Kiweed's. Not sure how much I'm going to use those ones. I like this meter that they sent me. It's become the favorite one. Partly because it's got a huge display, which you guys can usually see on camera, not too bad. This one's got an easier to read display, but it's a monochrome display. This one is color. They're decent meters for hobby. I'll give them that. And they're cheap, so why not? Anyway, thanks for watching. Questions and comments as usual down below. Thanks to my Patreon supporters and my YouTube channel members and anybody who clicked that super thanks button down below. I appreciate the cash flow. It helps keep my beer fridge full and it helps me keep these mailbags coming in. because this would get expensive otherwise. Yeah, that's all for tonight. Talk to you later.